بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أخيارتا شاشة لها نقالة جان قادة إيه وليبا ساحي بدا قيمها إيه قدرين تمودان وقهرين وحان إذن الله يهي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته مقعيقي وعبد القدوس نور صالح دوني علي وحان كمي دهي مسؤوليين تا حفيزكا دقمتا اللي حاد مقالة دا منيابلس كسو دوادا كنا سو دوركا برنامج وينو إذن كوسو بندقينو قلب دوان لو قد يقي مقالة دا بوساسو إيه حرونتا قبلكا بري.
And we are now ready to take our vote. We have a motion before us on approval of the resolution establishing a sister city relationship with Bosaso, Somalia.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? That motion is approved.
dabayaaqadii 2014 kii bay ahayd xilli gudoomiyaha degmada lixaad ee magaalada Minneapolis mudane Cabdi Warsame uu meel mariyay qaraar lagu mataaneeyay magaalooyinka Minneapolis iyo Bosaso dadweynaha Soomaaliyeed ee ku sugan magaalada Minneapolis iyo dunida dacaladeedii ayaa arintaasii aad iyo aad u soo dhaweeyay isla markaana ku tilmaamay talaabo go'doonka looga saaraya dalka Soomaaliya hadaba tan iyo mataaneyntii goortii la sameeyay maxaa u hirgalay magaalada Minneapolis maxaa u hirgalay magaalada Bosaso sanadkii 2015ka ayaa xafiiska degmada lixaad oo kaashanaya gudi ka kooban jaaliyada Soomaaliyeed ee Minneapolis iyo waliba shaqaalaha magaalada Minneapolis iyo hay'ad maxalli ah oo ka howlgasha magaalada Minneapolis ayaa waxa ay gaarsiiyeen deeqdii u horeysay oo la gaarsiiyay magaalada Bosaso deeqdaasi oo ka koobnayd 10,000 oo buwaag isla markaana ay gudoomeen wasaaradda waxbarashada dawladda Puntland bil ka hor bay ahayd xilli aad aragteen saashadaha ka aragteen iyo waliba jaraa'idyada ka howlgala magaalada Minneapolis in magaalada Minneapolis golaheeda deegaanka ay si aqlabiyad ah u ansixiyeen deeqdii u ballaarnayd abid la gaarsiiyo magaalo ka mid ah magaalooyinka mataanaha la ah Minneapolis deeqdaasi ayaa ka koobnayd qayb dabdamis ah qayb xarun dambi baaris ah iyo waliba qalab kale oo dheeraad ah oo loogu talagalay gawaarida shilalka gala hadaba inta aan barnaamijkan idin fasaxin aan u mahadnaqo maamulka degmada Bosaso oo soo dalbaday deeqdaasi oo uu horkacay gudoomiyaha degmadaasi injineer Yasiin Mire iyo waliba xogayaha dawladda hoose ee magaalada Bosaso mudane Cabdirasaaq Geeldoon waxaan sidoo kale u mahadnaqaynaa jaaliyada Soomaaliyeed ee Minneapolis gudiga Minnesota Friends of Bosaso ururka Soomaaliyeed ee ka joog iyo dhammaan intii ka qayb qaadatay gaarsiinta deeqdan iyo waliba dalabkeedii
magacaygu waa Cabdi Warsame gudoomiyaha degmada lixaad maanta waxaan joognaa xarunta dabdamiska magaalada Minneapolis oo waxaan la joogo chief Frido oo ah chiefka magaalada dhinaca dabdamiska iyo waxaan la joogay Cali Ciise oo xiriirka magaalada Minneapolis iyo Bosaso oo asna waqtigiisa ka soo qaatay inuu no volunteer gareeyo una socdo dalkii waxaan rabnaa inaan tusno maanta deeqdii dhinaca dabdamiska ee magaalada Minneapolis ay uu noogu deeqday waana ku mahadsan tahay chiefka marka hore uu dhiibaya and then gudoomiye Cali Ciise ayaa noo sharxi doona inta
ka dib it's an awesome opportunity for us to be able to donate these fire apparatus to Somalia to continue the great service that they've provided for us hope to continue to provide the same service in Somalia they have been a really good rig for us I hope that they will serve the communities in Somalia very well in the future. Okay, mostly a little bit about the apparatus. They have 500 gallon water tanks, so they will carry 500 gallons of water. They will have you'll be able to put some hose on the back. You'll be able to actually pump with them. So you carry water. You arrive on scene with a fire, and you're going to be able to actually pump water through a hose and extinguish fires with these apparatus. You also be able to carry some medical gear if you choose, and could respond to a medical run, and firefighters could do some first aid if needed. And both rigs are very much the same. They also have the capability of a master stream appliance on both of the apparatus. For a very, very large fire, you can apply large volumes of water on that fire. So they're going to be very effective piece of equipment. They've served us well, and I wish you folks all the best.
Marka hore waxaan rabaa inaan ugu mahadceliyo Cabdi Warsame iyo Cabdi Qudus hawshii dheer ee u soo mareen inay qalabkan oo casriga ah in Bosaso oo helo aan waa maasantahay gudoomiyaha aan degmada lixaad ee Minneapolis aan marka labaad waxa weeye qalabkan waa qalab aad baahi loogu qabo boosaaso special magaaladii oo aad u weynatay ana dabdamiskan inuu wax weyn ka qaban doono baan jeclahay iyo sheybarka lab aan crimina aan crime labka aan waxa weeye qalabkan oo mar dhow iman doona haduu Ilaahay yiraado aan aad ba ugu faraxsanahay oo Cabdi oo maanta aan soo booqanay qalabkii aan soo aragnay aan wa maasan tahay gudoomiye marlaad.
Just talk a little bit briefly about how these apparatus work. This is what we consider our called the pump panel. This is all of the controls that make the fire engine actually work. We open and close these gates, and that applies water. The water will come out here down the hose line, and we can apply a lot of pressure to actually deliver water a great distance. So this is pretty much the control center for all of the operating of all the pumps and delivering the water. You can see up on top, if you can pan up on top, that's a master stream appliance. That appliance will deliver over 1,000 gallons of water a minute. So you have a large fire, you connect this rig to that, you can apply a lot of water into a very large fire, and it's very effective in extinguishing capability of that. And working down the side, we just have compartments, of just storage compartments that we use. You can put additional equipment in here, fire hose, connections, whatever you may want as far as your equipment, just different cabinetry to store any of the equipment that you may choose to put in based on what you decide to do in terms of capability in the country.
Maanta waxaan joognaa xarunta dambi baarista ee magaalada Minneapolis. Waxaan ku soo dhaweynayaa Shannon Johnson oo ah directorka dambi baarista ee magaalada Minneapolis. Shannon iyo anigu waxaan ka soo shaqeynaynay maxaalada deeqdii loo deeqay magaalada Boosaaso ee magaaladeena u deeqday oo kamid ahayd xarunta qalabka xarunta dambi baarista. Shannon, aan hadir u gudbinayaa.
Hi, I'm Shannon Johnson. I'm the director of the crime lab for the Minneapolis Police Department. And we are very happy to be able to be donating several pieces of equipment to our sister city of Boosaaso, Somalia, in order to help them start a crime lab. So some of the equipment that we are going to be donating to them are fingerprint processing kits, a metal detector, ultraviolet light sources, we have several of those that we'll be giving them, some flashlights, what we call an omnichrome alternate light source, a incriminator laser, a comparison microscope, and we will be donating our crime scene van to them as well.
Shannon Johnson, waxyaalahaan ugu deeqnay magaalada Boosaaso waxa kamid ah qalab fara badan oo qalabka faraha lagu baaro, qalabka xabadaha lagu baaro, iyo baawuur weyn oo poliiska ah oo baawuurka forensicska ah. Intaas loogu deeqay. Haddeerna waxaan samayn doonaa, waxaan tusi doonaa alaabihii la deeqay ayagoo laga shaqeynayo oo ayagoo shaqeynayo
Okay. So the fingerprint processing kits that we'll be donating, actually we're donating several items that will help with fingerprint development. Fingerprints are important in solving crimes because no two individuals are known to have the same fingerprints across the world. So we use them to individualize who might have been at a crime scene. Fingerprints, when you touch something, are naturally invisible, so we have to do something in order to develop them and be able to see them. We're donating fingerprint powder kits that we use commonly on like glass surfaces or other smooth surfaces, but basically we just use the powder to be able to visualize the fingerprints. So you can see here the start of a handprint. Where we couldn't see that before, we used the powder to develop it in order to be able to see it. We lift it. And then we put it on a slide in order to protect it and be able to view it on the computer and do comparisons. So this is the the powder and the brushes and these slides are some of the equipment that we will be donating. This is a laser. It's another piece of equipment that we'll be donating, and we use it for, again, for fingerprint processing and viewing fingerprints on items. We use it most commonly to process gun evidence and narcotics evidence. And so I have a couple of examples of items that I process. This is a discharged cartridge casing left behind at a scene. And this is just a glass bottle just to show you how the fingerprints will fluoresce on there. So right now you can't really see anything on here, but when I turn on the laser, the fingerprints will fluoresce under there. Now we have to turn on our goggles. You guys all have goggles? Okay. So you can see, you might need to get closer, but you can see here's a test print here. This is a fingerprint discharge cartridge casing. So you can see the fingerprints here. So what we did with this evidence was we used super glue to process it because, like I said, fingerprints are really fragile. You need something in order to preserve them. So we use super glue to basically make them indestructible, and then we spray a dye stain on them, and then we use the laser to visualize them. On here, it might be hard to see without having the goggles on, but you can just barely make out three little black dots right above the brim of the hat. These are little tiny blood stains that without the light source would be very difficult to see. So we have several light sources like this that we will be donating. They can also be used to look at sexual assault cases, blood, and other chemical processes as well. This is another piece of equipment that we will be donating. It's called a comparison microscope, and we use it to look at discharge cartridge casings and fired bullets from crime scenes. So what we have here is one cartridge casing on the left side and another cartridge casing on the right side, and we can use the microscope to visually examine them to determine if they were fired from the same handgun. You can see on the screen over here what exactly a firearms examiner is looking at to make that determination.
Kan wuxuu kamid yahay gaadiidkii aan ugu deeqnay magaalada Boosaaso waana gaadiidka dambi baarista magaalada Minneapolis waa u jeeda Minneapolis Crime Laboratory waa baawur loogu talagalay in dambiga lagu baaro waxa wuxuuna kamid yahay saddexdi gaadiid mid kamid ah kuwa aan ugu deeqnay.
So typically what we carry in our crime lab van is different kinds of equipment that we might need at any given crime scene. So we have a ladder in here in case we need to climb up to collect some evidence. We have some different digging tools. Sometimes we have to dig fired bullets out of the ground. We have some different lights in here, some footwear, casting material. If we have footwear at a crime scene, we can mix up the casting material to collect that footwear. We also have a metal detector. We talked about that earlier. We carry a metal detector in here. All of these are different pieces of equipment that we might need at a crime scene in order to be able to collect evidence.
Waad ku mahadsan tihiin daawashada aad daawateen barnaamijkan uu gudoomiyaha degmada Lixaad Mudane Cabdi Warsame uu ku soo bandhigayay deeq la gaarsiinaya dhawaan magaalada Boosaaso ee xarunta gobolka Bari.